Hello everyone, today in this video I will tell you how to perform the respiratory system examination. All the findings of respiratory system examination should be mentioned according to the anatomical areas of the chest. So there are four anatomical areas on the front of the chest. These are supraclavicular, infraclavicular, mammary and the inframammary area. Similarly, axillary area is divided into superior axillary, middle axillary and the inferior axillary area. And the back of the chest is divided into five anatomical areas: suprascapular, interscapular, scapular, infrascapular and the basal area. So all the findings we have to mention according to the anatomical areas of the chest. We have to start the respiratory system examination with the examination of the nose, and the shape and the position of the nose should be mentioned. And then any abnormal finding, example, septum deviation, alanisi flaring, polyp discharge, we have to mention in the nose examination. Then we have to perform the inspection, palpation, percussion and auscultation. So in inspection, first is the shape of the chest, then the symmetry of the chest, then the movements of the chest, then the position of the trachea, then any signs of respiratory distress are present, then we have to mention, then we have to calculate the respiratory rate. So in shape of the chest, normally it is circular and cylindrical in shape. If you find because of the emphysema, it is barrel shape. Because of the rickets, it's funnel shape. Or if the patient is having the shoulder drooping because of the fibrosis and collapse, if the patient is having bulging because of the pleural effusion pneumothorax, you have to mention in the shape. Then symmetry of the chest, bilaterally chest is symmetrical or not. If you find any asymmetry, example, if the patient is having effusion, then the bulging will be there. If the patient is having shoulder drooping because of the collapse, if the patient is having kyphosis, scoliosis, so on the back, any abnormal asymmetry you have to mention. So in symmetry of the chest, if you find any asymmetry is there, then you have to mention. And after that, we have to look for the movements of the chest and the expansion of the chest, bilaterally equal or not. Normally, abdominothoracic respiration is present in the infant. After that, it becomes the thoracoabdominal in a female child and abdominothoracic in a male child. And we have to also look for the expansion of chest bilaterally. Then the position of trachea. In inspection, if you find that the clavicular head of the sternocleidomastoid muscle is burst out on one side, that means trachea is shifted on that side. In this picture, you can see the child is having the trachea in central position. That's why clavicular head of the both the sternocleidomastoid muscles are normal. So we have to mention the position of trachea. After that, any signs of respiratory distress are present, example, suprasternal retraction, subcostal retraction, intercostal retraction, alanisi flaring, you have to mention. So in this video, you can see the child is having respiratory distress and intercostal retraction are present. So you have to mention and calculate RR. Then the second part is palpation. So in palpation, first we have to confirm all the findings of the inspection by performing the palpation. And in palpation, first position of the trachea will be confirmed. Movements of the chest bilaterally equal or not, we have to compare the expansion of the chest bilaterally. And then we have to feel for any abnormal vibration, example, crackles, ronchi, pleural friction rub. Then test for the tactile vocal fremitus should be done, then apex beat, then look for any tenderness. So in this video, you can see I am performing the trail sign. In this, we have to keep the ring finger and index finger on the clavicular head of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and we have to move the middle finger into the midline. And if it is moving in midline, that means trachea is in center. If it is dipping on the any side, right or left, that means the trachea is shifted to that side. This is the trail sign. After that, four movements of the chest, we have to keep the both the hands on the shoulder, and when patient will do the inspiration, we have to see the movements of the shoulder. And similarly, on the front of the chest, we have to encircle the palm on the chest and put the thumb into the midline and see the movements of the thumb from the midline. If it is equal distance, that means it is normal. So in this video, child is having normal respiration and both the thumbs are moving from the midline to the equal distance. So expansion of the chest is also bilaterally equal. And the movements are also present. So similarly, on the back of the chest, we have to encircle the palm and we have to see the movements of the thumb which are present in the midline. Now I am performing the test for the tactile vocal fremitus. In this we have to use the ulnar border of our palm. In all the anatomical areas we have to keep the ulnar border of palm on the both side of the chest, on front, on back, and we have to tell the patient to speak the some words, example 1 2 3 1 2 3. If the baby is too small, example infant, then when the baby will cry, we have to compare the vibration sound on the both the sides. So this is the test, tactile vocal fremitus. So after that we have to put the palm in all anatomical area for feeling of any abnormal vibration and for any tenderness. Example in pleurisy, in pleural friction rub, examples some coarse crackles or ronchi can be feel. Now after palpation I am performing the percussion. In this plexometer finger, middle finger of non dominant hand should be placed in the contact with the chest, and the another finger, which is the plexus, middle finger of another dominant hand, strike the second phalanx of the plexometer finger, and always we have to move from the resonant to the dull note, and we have to compare the both side of the chest also. So this is the way to perform the percussion. And if you find the normal note is present bilaterally in all anatomical area, then you have to mention. If you find any abnormal note, example dull, tympanic or hyper resonant in particular anatomical area, you have to mention. Now I am showing you direct light percussion. Whenever organ is very superficial, example the apex of the lung, we can perform the direct light percussion. In this video you can see I am directly percussing the clavicle for the apex of the lung. So in this we have to use the plexar finger only. Now I am performing auscultatory percussion, in which we have to strike the gently manubrii, and we have to auscultate the back of the chest in all anatomical areas. And whenever lesion is very small, less than 3 cm in the size, or hilar or mediastinal lymph node, or atelectasis or bronchopneumonia, then by auscultatory percussion we can easily detect. So this is all about percussion. Now the auscultation. In auscultation we have to auscultate all the anatomical areas on the front, back and in axilla, for the intensity of the breath sound, for the character of the breath sound, for adventitious sound and for vocal resonance. So first is intensity of the breath sound. In all the anatomical areas we have to auscultate and we have to compare bilaterally for the intensity of the breath sound. If you find that air entry is decreased on any one side, or intensity of the breath sound is decreased on any one side, that means the pathology is present on that side of the lung. Now after that we have to auscultate for the character of the breath sound. Normal character of the breath sound is vesicular breath sound, in which there is a inspiration is long and loud, there is a no pause, it is followed by the short and low pitch expiration, which is a normal breathing sound, vesicular. In children sometime expiration is also little bit harsh, labeled as a bronchovesicular. And the third one is the bronchial breathing, which is the pathological, in which the inspiration and expiration both are of equal duration, but expiration is harsh and tubular in quality, and there is a pause between inspiration and expiration. It is seen in the consolidation, cavities or fistula. There are again three types of the bronchial breathing: amphoric, tubular, cavernous. So this is about the character of the breath sound. Now the for the adventitious sounds we have to auscultate all the anatomical areas. So it may be the wheeze because of the obstruction of the air passage. If obstruction of the air passage is present anywhere from the bronchioles, bronchi, then the wheezing sound, this is the musical sound which will be audible. And it may be during the inspiration or during the expiration, depends on the pathology and depends on where is the obstruction. और इट मे बी मोनोफोनिक और पॉलीफोनिक, डिपेंड्स ऑन द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज लोकलाइज्ड और जनरलाइज्ड. एग्जाम्पल, लोकलाइज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द ब्रोंकस इज देयर, देन द मोनोफोनिक वीजिंग साउंड विल बी देयर. इफ द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज जनरलाइज एज इन द अस्थमा, देन द पॉलीफोनिक वीजिंग साउंड विल बी देयर. एंड अनादर इज द क्रेपिटेशन एंड क्रैकल्स विच इज सीन इन द कंसोलिडेशन ब्रोंकेक्टेसिस, और इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग द bronchitis, this is the bubbling or wheat sound which is produced by the passage of air through the exudate which is collected in the alveoli, bronchioles or in the bronchi. So these are the adventitious sounds. Now I am performing the test for the vocal resonance, in which we have to auscultate all the anatomical areas and we have to tell the patient to speak the 1 2 3 1 2 3. And we have to compare intensity and quality of the sound which is transmitted through the chest piece of the stethoscope. And there are various other terminology. If when you are performing the test for the vocal resonance and increased vocal resonance is there and it is so loud that it appears that the sound is being produced in the earpiece of the stethoscope, that means it is bronchophony. Now if you tell the patient to just whisper certain words and still it is audible, we label as a whispery pectoral leaky, which is seen in the bronchopleural fistula. And another is the egophony, in which is seen in the pleural effusion at the level, upper level of the pleural effusion, in which the nasal twang or bleating quality of the sound will be audible. So this is about the auscultation part. Now I will show you some tests which we have to perform in the auscultation. These are the coin test, friction test, suction splash. In this video you can see I am performing the coin test. A coin is placed in the front of the chest and another coin, just we have to tap the coin and we have to auscultate the back of the chest in all the areas. A loud bell-like twinkle sound will be audible in a patient with the pneumothorax. Now in this video you can see I am performing the friction test. A chest piece is placed in the center of the chest and the friction is produced on either side of the chest wall with the wooden spatula, or you can friction with the nail also. And the conduction of the sound will be better when the chest is scratched on the side of the pneumothorax. So this is the friction test. So coin test and friction test both are helpful for the pneumothorax. Now I am performing the test suction splash. Whenever there is a pleural effusion, and splash should be elicited to rule out the hydropneumothorax. In this, the chest piece is affixed at the upper border of the dullness and child is suddenly shaken to elicit the splash of the fluid. So this is suction splash. So this is all about the respiratory system examination. Thank you so much.